Welcome back, everybody. What is up? It is Fox at FoxyGames_UK with another video. Now, there was no The Gamer Couch podcast yesterday because of Father's Day, but it will return this Sunday. Now, go ahead, subscribe to the channel and follow via Twitter for your source of aggregate news, rumor, and video game discussion with an emphasis on PlayStation, but spanning a variety of platforms. Now, if you're new to the channel, welcome on board. Let us know how you found us and remember to hit the notification bell so you never miss content, and remember to thumbs up if you liked the video. Some views expressed in our videos are those of third parties and do not necessarily represent the views of Foxy Games UK, and all relevant links can be found in this video's description. Okay, let's get straight into it then. With talk of PS5 development becoming ever more prevalent, and now head of Microsoft Gaming Phil Spencer announcing at this year's E3 a next-gen Xbox is in the works, codenamed Scarlet. Now you have to ask, was the next-gen Xbox announcement designed to get Sony to move a little sooner rather than later, so that Microsoft can observe PS5's final system specification, then attempt to best it in power? Now we all know Xbox One launched back in 2013, noticeably underpowered to its counterpart PS4, and Microsoft took a lot of shtick because of it, even prompting the design of the Xbox One X so that Microsoft, much like OG Xbox and to some degree Xbox 360, will once again hold the power advantage. Now I would go as far as to say that perhaps Team Xbox have a desire to replicate the Xbox 360's early success. Early in that system, really it launched first and managed to secure and retain years of exclusivity from various developers and publishers worldwide, some even strongly aligned with Sony PlayStation. So what do we know about Project Scarlet? Well, for sure, I expect all software to be backwards compatible, since that is Microsoft's mantra, and expect real deal 4K and not the uncompromised promises of a compromised mid-gen refresh. Expect all the E3 2018 games Microsoft revealed to drop years from now. The likes of Halo Infinity, for example, will highly likely release on the next-gen Xbox, with severely scaled back Xbox One versions that will look tired next to a 2020/2021 Xbox. Now, Xbox One games could look and perform so poorly by that time, Digital Foundry probably won't even bother to include it in their comparison videos. Likely it'll be Xbox One X versus Xbox One Next, everything from load times, visuals, frame rate, and overall performance. Looking to the past strategies for answers, typically Microsoft and Sony announce next-gen consoles every 5 or so years. Now with the 360 and PS3 generation exceeding 7 years due to a globally weak economic environment, but with the increasing demand for power by developers and the discerning gaming public's desire for the next big thing, Sony's 4.2 TFLOP PS4 Pro and Microsoft's Xbox One X with its 6 TFLOPs of raw compute power actually managed to run a few top-tier titles at native 4K. Though the bulk of those titles really had to rely on visual trickery to hit 4K in many cases, often at the expense of performance, these consoles introduced checkerboard rendering and dynamic resolution for the first time in their respective generations. Both consoles are slowly moving toward PC-like options too, allowing console gamers to choose priorities, frame rate over resolution. Now what can we expect in the next generation of consoles? Well, expect more of the same next gen, only far more emphasis on the aforementioned. This year has seen even more rumors of Sony's next gen console, the PS5, and there's no smoke without fire, make no mistake. Sony Interactive Entertainment's CEO John Cadera even told the Wall Street Journal PS4 is entering the final phase of its life cycle, which would have a negative impact to the unit, but reoccurring revenue via membership services should cushion some of that. Now, considering both the original launch PS4 and Xbox One are approaching a full 5 years on the market, and by November 2020 it'll be 7 years straight, don't be surprised if any of the two companies start teasing their consoles at some point in 2019, particularly in Sony's case. Though it must be said that I'm a little bit curious, given that Xbox One X launched some 7 to 8 months ago and Microsoft are already talking about next gen Xboxes. I mean, the last thing you want to hear after laying down $500 or 449 Great British pounds is that powerful 6 TFLOP console you may just have invested in is already being replaced with something far more capable, and fairly soon. Yes, we know the pace of technology moves fast and it waits for no man, but it's not really something Microsoft needs needed to announce this soon, especially if this new Xbox is two or more years away. My opinion, and it's just an opinion, I don't have any facts, but I suspect Microsoft are trying to provoke Sony into showing their hand first and quickly. It's a gamble that could backfire on Microsoft if the company isn't careful, and announcing new Xboxes so soon after November 2017's Xbox One X launch seems, well, a little reckless to me. Indeed, Microsoft surprised many when Phil Spencer clearly hinted that another next-generation console is in the works. During their on-stage E3 conference, head of Xbox Phil Spencer said, and I quote, "Our hardware team, the same team that delivered unprecedented performance with Xbox One X, is deep into architecting the next Xbox consoles, where we will once again deliver on our commitment to deliver the benchmark of console gaming." This sudden announcement leads me to believe that Microsoft simply said this for now as a marketing talk to deter gamers from the PlayStation 5 hype that Sony have been building over the past few months. Dubbed as Scarlet for now, the words Phil Spencer have said at the event were rather interesting. Phil Spencer mentioned that they are working on their next-gen consoles. Yes, consoles. This would lead me to personally believe that this next-gen mysterious Xbox consoles would be released in multiple variants, most probably two variants. Now, should either Sony or Microsoft plan to release its next-generation console over the next 2 years or so, the burning question should be just how much of a substantial upgrade to the One X and Pro will we see, and just how much are the consumers expected to pay for the privilege of boasting mine's better than yours? Look at the swath of visually impressive games this generation, particularly the likes of Sony's own first-party flagship content. How much of an improvement do we really expect to see? Both Sony's PlayStation 4 and Microsoft's Xbox One X are catering to their enthusiast gamers pretty well, at least for the time being. You've got 4K, you've got high dynamic range, you've got 30 and 60 FPS options, near photorealism, and a depiction of impressively rendered human character models as seen in Quantum Break, God of War, Detroit Become Human, hell, even The Order 1886 and Rise Son of Rome both visually look like they could have launched this year. But we have to look at timelines. Take the PlayStation 4 Pro, it's been on the market for almost 17 months, and while the Xbox One X has only been on the shelves around 8 months, Microsoft, and to Sony, some extent Sony, but less so, while both of these industry players are already talking about upgrades, which will undoubtedly piss off a lot of people. Though, if you just purchased an OG Xbox One or vanilla PS4, you really ought not to complain. It's been close to 5 years already. Early adopters should not have to wait for Johnny come latelys. Still, hopefully the concern is premature, as there's still a few years down the line for both companies to iron out any potential issues, though the announcement of yet another Xbox so soon admittedly caught me off guard. So, with Microsoft revealing they're planning a few next-gen Xbox consoles, really disturbing enough, even if the experienced core console gamer really is simple enough to convert, it could be an uphill struggle convincing casuals they need to drop another, potentially $400 to $500 for yet another console promising even more 4K, more HDR, with slightly faster loading times. But do let us know your thoughts and opinions on this new story, because that unfortunately brings us to the end of another video. But let's continue the discussion in the video comments, and for more PS4, Xbox One and Nintendo Switch coverage, subscribe to Foxy Games UK. And if you found any of the information in this video at all useful, why not hit the like button and help us reach more like-minded gamers simply by sharing the video. And for just $1, £1 or equivalent, become a member by joining the Foxy Games UK Patreon and help us grow. You can find a link in this video's description. Thank you for all your kind support. And so, there we have it. Until next time, always remember, regardless of platform, play games, not corporations. Thanks for watching, everybody.